How long is the flight to Delhi, Dad?
It's a 2.5-hour journey, JC.
We regret to inform you that flight AI-307 to New Delhi has been delayed by an hour. It will now leave the Chhatrapati Shivaji Airport at 400 hours. We are sorry for the inconvenience caused by this delay.
Oh no! That's our flight! It will now take off from here an hour late.
Dad, the lady who made the announcement called this airport Chhatrapati Shivaji Airport. Is that what it's called? I thought it was called Mumbai Airport.
The official name of the airport is Chhatrapati Shivaji International Airport.
Why is it named after Chhatrapati Shivaji? Who is he?
JC, Shivaji was a great Maratha warrior.
Please, Dad, tell me about Chhatrapati Shivaji.
Okay, since we have the time, I can tell you kids about Shivaji.
We are ready, Dad.
Yeah.
When was Shivaji born?
Shivaji was born in 1627. He founded the powerful Maratha kingdom with the support of the Deshmukhs, who were powerful warrior families.
How did Shivaji fight the Mughals? Weren't they very powerful?
Till when did Shivaji lead the Marathas?
Shivaji led the Marathas till 1680.
So, did the Maratha rule come to an end?
No, the kingdom continued to flourish. It was then ruled by the Peshwa.
Peshwa?
After Shivaji died, a family of Chitpavan Brahmins served as his successors. They were called Peshwas or Principal Minister. They made Pune the capital of the Maratha kingdom.
Were the Peshwas also good rulers?
Yes, they were successful against the Mughals because they followed a particular military strategy.
What was that?
They raided only those cities where their supplies and reinforcements could easily be distributed. They bypassed the big fortified Mughal areas.
Mom, I have to go to the restroom. Will you please come with me?
Okay.
I need to stretch my legs a bit. Are you boys coming?
I'll come with you, Dad.
JC, can you please stay here and look after the luggage? We'll be back soon.
Okay, Dad. Hey, that's a picture of Shivaji on his horse. I really want to know what happened to the Maratha kingdom.
Hold on, boy. Calm down.
Hello, brave Shivaji. I am JC. I want to ask you about your kingdom.
Hi, JC. My kingdom grew steadily between 1720 and 1761. Malwa and Gujarat were taken from the Mughals in the 1720s. And then, by the 1730s, the Maratha king was recognized as the overlord of the whole Deccan Peninsula.
Really?
Yes. He had the right to levy taxes in the entire region.
That's impressive.
And that's not all. In 1737, the Marathas raided Delhi and spread their domination into Rajasthan and Punjab in the north, Bengal and Orissa in the east, and Karnataka, Tamil and Telugu countries in the south.
Then the Maratha kingdom must have been really huge.
Yes, it was. However, the above places were not added to the kingdom, but were made to pay tribute as a way of accepting the Maratha sovereignty.
Oh, so the Maratha kingdom must have been quite rich.
Yes, these military expansions brought a lot of resources, but they also made the rulers of the kingdoms hostile towards the Marathas. That's the reason why they did not support the Marathas in the Third Battle of Panipat in 1761. But military conquest was not the only thing that we Marathas were good at. the Maratha rulers also developed an excellent administrative system.
So did the common people benefit from the Maratha rule?
Yes. After an area was conquered, the Maratha rulers introduced revenue demands in keeping with the local conditions. They encouraged agriculture and revived trade. The regions prospered under them.
Can you give me some examples of such rulers?
Maratha chiefs or sardars like Sindhya of Gwalior, Gaikwad of Baroda, and Bhosle of Nagpur ruled their people in a stable way. This allowed them to raise powerful armies as well.
Tell me more about the Maratha rulers.
When the Marathas conquered Malwa in the 1720s, they did not hamper the growth of the region. Ujjain prospered under the Sindhyas and Indore under Holkers. These cities continued to be important cultural and commercial hubs.
So the Marathas actually helped them prosper.
That's correct. New trade routes emerged within the Maratha Empire.
How is that?
For example, the silk produced in Chanderi now found its way to Pune, the Maratha capital. Burhanpur, which earlier traded only with Agra and Surat, could now trade with Nagpur and Pune in the south and Lucknow and Allahabad in the east. So you see, JC, the kingdom that I started was a great one.
Yes, it was. That's why you are remembered even today. Did you know that this airport is named after you?
Really? I had no idea. Anyways, I better go now. People around you are beginning to think that you are talking to yourself.
Thank you, Shivaji.
Sorry, JC, for taking so long. Hope you didn't get too bored.
Oh no, I found a friend who kept me company.
Which friend?
Someone you all know.